Yo, shout out Yuri Noto Vibes, your boy Ron Shuno. You here with One Track Mind. And it's another interview. Tune in right now. We going crazy. Boom.
Ron Shuno in the building.
Ron Shuno.
Bronx only. Ron Shuno.
She wanna ride like a 44. I keep me a duck like 44. You cannot touch like this. Can't move like this. Got swag like Mike. You cannot touch like this. Can't move like this. Got swag like Mike.
I just wanted to ask you. You're from New York, obviously. What do you think about this whole King of New York conversation? What's your stance on there?
Yeah, I feel like people were so busy trying to be the king of New York when I feel like their vision should be to be king of the world, you heard? Like, they so worried about being the title of their state, they got to take over the whole world, like, you feel me? I feel like it's cool to be a king of your borough, you feel me, your state. That's just for your hometown. But why not elevate and take over the whole thing, you feel me? So I just feel like that King of New York shit corny.
All right, yeah, so you're out here going for king of the world. Who do you feel like in the game of, like, in the rap game is the king of the world right now?
King of the world,
yeah.
That it gotta be they alive or they gotta be dead.
Either or, your call.
Cause you know, I ain't gonna lie. When I say me, for real. Facts. I gotta go wrong sooner. He's legendary.
That's definitely the best approach to take. You also mentioned that early on in your career, you looked up to artists like Soulja Boy and Chief Keef. Mm-hmm. Did you have a chance to link up with either of them? And, like, if so, what was your experience like?
Oh, nah. I didn't meet up with them yet, but I'm looking forward to actually meeting up with Soulja Boy and Chief Keef. You feel me? Like, my goal is to get that feature out of Chief Keef because, you know, I'm a drill rapper and I like to do a lot of music. So it's like him being from Chicago and me doing drill in New York, that'd be fire. Me and him did drill together. The Soulja Boy, you feel me? Real soon, I feel like that link gonna come soon because he play Xbox, and I got Xbox too, so I'm gonna try to add him online one day and see if I can play him in 2K.
Yeah. And have you spoken to any of these guys on DMs or anything at all yet, or are you just waiting for the time to come?
Now I'm just waiting for the right time because, you know, I like things to be genuine, you feel me? Like, I'd rather me just meet them in person so I can get the full, you know, experience of just meeting them and showing them the real me, you heard? So, as always, like, even in life, when you meet somebody, it just gotta be genuine. You don't want anything to be forced.
Yeah, for sure. Mm-hmm. And speaking on the topic of, like, influences and people you looked up to, have you linked up with anyone that you did look up to that I didn't mention since you've kind of, like, blossomed into the rapper you've become?
Nah, because I still ain't meet Trey Songz yet, so I ain't meet nobody I look up to yet. But I mean, my set Trey Songz is lit. For me, I look up to Trey Songz too. But other than that, everybody that I met that was in the industry, it was mad cool, you feel me? It was down to earth, you feel me? So I ain't gonna lie. Shout out to everybody that I work with, like Blueface. I like Blueface, he mad cool. I like 504, you heard. I met Trippie Redd. Trippie Redd cool too, you feel me? There's mad people that's cool. So it's like the social media is a different story. When you meet people in real life, it's a different, you feel me, situation.
All right, yeah. And you mentioned that you, like, linked up with 504. You also have a track with Smooth L. You have tracks, obviously, yeah, with people out of New York. You also recently welcomed to the party. And since you're tight with all these people from New York and you are from New York, I was wondering, do you have a relationship with Pop Smoke before his passing?
Nah, it's so crazy. I actually didn't know Pop Smoke, you know? Like, I knew about him. I knew the people that he be around. But me knowing Pop Smoke, like, me and him, I never knew him. And it's crazy because I definitely wanted to work with him. And it's sad that he had to go so fast. And with the talent that he had right now, it's crazy. But I never met him.
And just to add, Ron Shuno was supposed to be booked for his performance a week after he passed. He had a booking to perform with Pop. So yeah. It's sad that it didn't happen.
Okay. That's right. I ain't gonna lie.
On that a little bit, like, you were supposed to perform with Pop Smoke, right? How did that come to be? Like, how did it go down? How did you find out that you were supposed to be performing alongside Pop?
Shout out to Avery because she my publicist. I guess you got contact with Pop Smoke brother, right? That was that situation.
They already was, like, interested in Ron, which is being a part of just Pop Smoke's foundation and being that ambassador. Yeah. To help the youth understand, you know, what it takes to be a creative, how to be an artist, how to be a comedian. So they wanted him to be, like, an ambassador to help the youth with the community arts. So with Pop Smoke's foundation. So that's still in the works, but the album came out. The album is titled The Same Foundation. The nonprofit is the same title. So everything's tying in. Ron's going to definitely, you know, keep the torch going for Pop. Mm-hmm.
Well, most definitely. Most definitely. You're gonna go crazy.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure. And early, like in a couple other interviews, you mentioned that you started drill early on when you were like 13, 14 years old. You were big on that New York drill scene. Had you heard of Pop Smoke before he was even bubbling outside of there?
Nah, because at the time when I was 13, I was listening to Chief Keef more. I was into like the Chicago wave. Like, I was mainly like, when I was younger, I liked how Chicago was doing the drill. So it made me want to do drill, I'm going to be honest with you. Like, because I always rapped all my life. But what made me go in that studio is the simple fact that I seen like certain people that I look up to do it, and I wanted to do it too. So for me, that whole Chicago drill made a little influence on me. I'm about to drop another Swag Like Mike Volume 2, you heard? This shit gonna have like 12 songs on it, you feel me? This is more of a like a versatile Ron Suno, more features, more worldwide features, and like a different sound that I'm bringing to the media, a different sound I'm bringing to New York, because a lot of times people hear the same sound as recycled, you feel me? It's a lot of stuff going on, so I'm gonna bring something different.
Yo, Ron Suno, you know the vibes, man. You was just tuning in with One Track Mind. Stay tuned, Ron Suno. We going crazy every day. 2020 got some shoes. They ready to bang them, lose it. I might hop out that Buick. You feel me? Shit, name.
Extended the clip like Pinocchio. I think that I'm half the Dosey though. She wanna ride like a Vodio. I keep me a dog like 44. You cannot touch like this. Can't move like this. Got swag like Mike. You cannot touch like this. Can't move like this. Got swag like Mike.